Hi, I'm Robert Harsh, YouTube channel Basso 9x13, and welcome to Goodbye Blue Sky, How and Why, Part 1. A while back I posted a video slideshow with photos I took in Hawaii and Montana, North Dakota, and Washington, D.C., and I accompanied it with my solo bass guitar version of Goodbye Blue Sky by Roger Waters. In this little series, I'm going to take you through how I play that song. Now, this is not meant to be any sort of a master class in definitive bass technique. There are far better people out there to address bass technique than me. This is more of a look at how I play this composition and the choices I make that led to the arrangement I came up with. Now, to begin with, let's talk about source material. Anytime you're going to cover a song, it's a good idea to have heard it once or twice. Preferably, if you can come up with a few different recordings by different artists, you can get an idea of how other people have adapted the song.
Versions in my collection include the original 1978 studio recording of Pink Floyd, The Wall, Pink Floyd, The Film, Roger Waters and Friends in 1989, live in Berlin and Potsdamer Platz, the DVD release of that concert. In this version, Goodbye Blue Sky is sung by Joni Mitchell, and James Galway provides some nice flute fills. Also from 1989, David Palmer and the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra performing Objects of Fantasy, the music of Pink Floyd. And Back Against the Wall, produced by one-time Yes Man Billy Sherwood, includes performances with Rick Wakeman, Keith Emerson, Chris Squire, Alan White, and many, many more. This version of Goodbye Blue Sky is sung by Billy Sherwood, and the guitar is played by Yes's Steve Howe. And, of course, the DVD release of Pink Floyd, The Wall. Additional source material comes in the form of sheet music. The original piano portfolio. Piano transcriptions will leave a lot out of your average rock and roll pop song, and there are going to be plenty of differences. But it gives you an idea of some of the things that are going on in the song. For a little bit more detailed look, the guitar tab is your transcription of the same album. Album folio transcriptions for guitar usually include all the guitar parts played on the album in a multi-tracked version, and include a lot of performance expression techniques like hammer-ons, slides, pull-offs, vibrato, whammy bar use, and so forth. So that's a great tool to learn some techniques there. It should be noted, however, that guitar tablature editions are meant for the six-string guitar parts and usually don't include the bass parts. Fortunately, I'm not playing the bass part. And finally, for an additional visual reference, I have a copy of Pink Floyd, The Wall, the film souvenir portfolio. This book includes all of the lyrical content to the movie, and it also includes some still frame photographs taken from the film.
And when dealing with a band as iconic as Pink Floyd, it's probably a good idea to have some familiarity with the rest of their catalog, too.
Now let's talk about gear. I performed this song on a four-string acoustic bass guitar. This is a Kamen, K-A-M-A-N, Applause, AA-40. Straight acoustic. There are no pickups involved. I use a Dean Markley sound hole pickup that was intended for a six-string guitar. To the best of my knowledge, there are no sound hole pickups for acoustic bass guitars specifically designed. However, most acoustic bass guitars you'll find today do have pickups built into them. This one I got in 1990 from a music store in Eugene, Oregon. It was the first acoustic bass I'd ever seen. Now, this being a short-scale bass, it's only 30 inches from the nut down to the bridge, which means all your notes are a little bit closer together than they would be on a standard-scale bass, long scale, that is, which is 34 inches from the nut to the bridge. The short scale on the Applause makes for a very portable bass, and it's also very comfortable for doing chordal work and triples and double stops. The Dean Markley pickup feeds into a Line 6 BassPod XT Live processing pedal. I essentially use the factory patch that was designed for the Variax guitar emulator for the Variax bass set on a jazz upright patch. I do, however, use the chorus modulation and the delay and reverb as programmed by the factory. I changed the EQ settings a little bit and monkeyed with the gain and the output level. The bass pod and two condenser mics then feed into a Yamaha AW16G digital recorder, which I'm really just using as a mixer to feed into my computer so I can record this video. And that's the gear I use. Now there's one important modification that I made to this bass, and that is called the drop detuning. You have your standard G string, your standard D string, your standard A string, but instead of a low E, I tune it down one full step to a low D, which adds a nice full bottom. Now, while I said this was not going to be any sort of a lesson in bass technique, there is one very important playing tool that I use, and that is harmonics. Harmonics are the natural overtone series that comes from essentially doubling the vibrating speed of the string by cutting it in half. And there are other people who can explain the physics of sound better than I can also. But you get the harmonics by playing the string and hitting it very lightly at certain points. You don't press all the way down, just hit it light and release and let it ring out. You'll find them at the first harmonic is at the 12th fret, your fundamental being the open string. First harmonic is an octave. Second harmonic is a fifth at the 7th fret, and at the 5th fret you have another octave. And you'll find a third right around here. Probably find another fifth. An octave. It's probably a seventh right in between. A dominant seventh or flatted seventh. And then there's ones that you can almost play a scale, just like Maynard Ferguson up there in the stratosphere. They're harder to hit, but fool around in different places, you will find them duplicated. For instance, up here. Some will ring better than others, and it depends on where your hands are positioned, which ones you decide to use. Fool around with them, find where they are. And that covers my preparation and setup for how I play Goodbye Blue Sky. Come back for part two, start actually learning how to play the song. Stay tuned.